I've done a lot of videos on the toxic effect of alcohol on the liver, but I haven't done a video showing the effects of alcohol on the heart tissue. So let's talk about that. There is a condition called alcoholic heart muscle disease, where the heart becomes very dysfunctional because of the chronic use of alcohol. But alcohol in general will create several problems with the heart tissue. One is it causes an increase of acetaldehyde accumulation. Now, I've done videos on this on the liver, and this chemical is considered a toxin or a poison. It's responsible for that, the feeling of a hangover, and the body will try to use certain enzymes to get rid of this toxin. Well, the same enzymes in the heart also are trying to get rid of this toxic poison, which is a residue from the alcohol. Also, you'll get a decreased protein synthesis on the myocytes. So the heart cell is made out of muscle, and it needs protein to rejuvenate. So you're not going to get a nice turnover of heart cells. Dilated chambers, so you have different parts of the heart. Okay, you have four chambers, and these chambers, as they start to enlarge, they don't all enlarge on a symmetry basis. Like the right side might enlarge more than the left, and that creates all sorts of problems. It can also create arrhythmia problems and murmurs, because now as the heart is enlarged, the valves no longer close like they're supposed to. Also, there's going to be increased inflammation in the heart, which really leads to a lot of problems with calcium buildup, cholesterol buildup, fibrosis of the heart tissue, arrhythmias. And then we have another effect of a decreased ejection fraction and a decreased contractibility. So this contraction of the pump, which is supposed to push the blood throughout the body, is impaired. We also get a decrease of anti-apoptosis pathways. Now, what does that mean? There are certain pathways that are there to help the survival of the heart muscle cell, called the myocyte. Apoptosis is where the cell actually dies. So we have anti-heart muscle cell death, right? So with alcohol, you are going to decrease the effect of this protective mechanism, and you'll have more heart cells that die. And then we get an increase of calcium that accumulates inside the cells. Now, normally we're supposed to have this ratio of way more calcium outside the cell than inside the cell. We do need calcium inside the cell, but that is very, very tightly regulated. And calcium acts as a communication particle in and out of the cell. One of the problems with alcohol is it drives too much calcium inside the cell, and you have all sorts of issues. And there's quite a few other things that will drive calcium inside the cell too, like EMF, electromagnetic fields, a problem with low potassium, because potassium protects this calcium overload. And what happens then is you'll start getting arrhythmias and palpitations and all sorts of problems with the pacemaker of the heart. Now, I know some of you are going to ask about, what about a little bit of wine each day? I heard that was good for the heart because of the phytonutrients, the antioxidants, the phenols, right? Well, yes, that is correct. But it's the exposure to ethanol that's the problem. If you were to consume a half a cup of wine, that may create a little bit of what's called a hormetic effect, which will add a little stress to cause the body to rebound, and you might see positive changes. But who is going to stop at a half a glass of wine per night? Probably not very many people. But I will say, if you're going to drink some wine occasionally and you want it to create more recovery, there are certain things that the heart loves. And the biggest thing that it loves is ketones, fat. The heart prefers fat fuel way over glucose fuel. And that would be the healthy keto and the intermittent fasting for sure, as a way to recover the damage that alcohol could create. The other two things that the heart loves are omega-3 fatty acids, okay, and vitamin E. But make sure the vitamin E includes tocotrienols, not just a synthetic tocopherol. All right, thanks for watching.
Hey, we're back
with another amazing recipe.
No grains, no sugar, totally keto. There's no suffering in keto.
Absolutely not, Karen.
And it's an immune system builder.
Absolutely. You have to check this out.
I think you should hurry up, watch the recipe, and make it yourself. It's just so easy to be keto.
But is it simple?
It's super simple.
We hope you enjoy making it as much as we are enjoying eating it.